parents and families, on behalf of the Lake Elsinore Unified School District Governing Board, our Superintendent Dr. Doug Kimberly, members of Cabinet, and last but not least, our amazing students, I want to welcome you to the 2021 Alternative Education Commencement Ceremony. My name is Dr. Greg Cleave, and I'm the proud principal of both Ortega High School and Valley Adult School. Along with Dr. Peter Hopping, the principal of Alternative Programs, we are so proud to celebrate you all today. We've all endured challenges and struggles in the last year that none of us could have imagined, but you've all shown the determination and will to rise above and achieve the success of earning your high school diploma. Whether you're wearing blue to represent Ortega High School, red to represent Keith McCarthy Academy, or white to represent Valley Adult School, your journey to a high school diploma is now complete. We all know that choosing an alternative school setting often comes with a history of challenges and struggles, but deciding on a new path is what ultimately led you to this moment. You've all proven that you are capable of overcoming obstacles, achieving amazing things, and nothing in this world can hold you back. You have all shown that opportunities don't happen, you create them. I'm extremely proud to have been part of your journey, and I appreciate the endless sacrifices and commitment to success that each of you has chosen in order to get to this point. I want you all to have the confidence to take on the world. I believe in you and know that you are all capable of doing amazing things and nobody can hold you back. On behalf of all the teachers and staff of Ortega High School and Valley Adult School, I want to wish a huge congratulations to the resilient class of 2021.
Congratulations to Keith McCarthy Academy and Valley Adult School class of 2021. I would like to welcome our distinguished guests, parents, guardians, family members, and staff, and the senior graduating class of 2021. It is my honor to introduce you to several dignitaries who have joined us this afternoon to celebrate a distinguished graduating class. Please help me in welcoming board members Heidi Dodd, board president, Juan Saucedo, board clerk, Stan Crippen, board member, Christopher McDonald, board member, and Susan Scott, board member. In addition, please welcome our LEUSD Executive Cabinet members, Dr. Doug Kimberly, Superintendent, Dr. Alan Guevara, Assistant Superintendent of Administrative Instructional Technology and Support Services, Dr. Kip Meyer, Assistant Superintendent of Student Instructional Support Services, Tracy Sepulveda, Assistant Superintendent of Personnel Support Services, Arlene Sanchez, Assistant Superintendent of Administrative and Fiscal Support Services, Melissa Valdez, Coordinator of Community and Media Relations. It is that time of year to celebrate. Although the 2020-2021 school year has been like none other in history, I'm happy to see our KMA senior class of 2021 putting on their caps and gowns and celebrating with friends and family members. The events that students have experienced over the course of their education, running from the joy, satisfaction, and relief they felt when accomplishing a personal goal, to the frustration, anger, and disappointment of falling short of expectations, have helped to build the foundation of determination and resiliency that are needed to pursue hopes, dreams, and goals well beyond the walls of Keith McCarthy Academy and the Lake Elsinore School District. Students, it is my hope that all of you have learned lessons that will last a lifetime from your time spent in our schools. Remember, it is your determination and tenacity that will make the difference in whether or not you achieve what you choose to do in the future. I would like to thank you, district officials, and the community for allowing our staff and I a position to support your educational and personal journeys at Keith McCarthy Academy this year. As you plan for your future, ask yourself, what does success mean? Is it money, health, being famous, a Fortune 500 career, having more than 1 million followers on your YouTube channel? Whatever your answer is, don't choose something that will jeopardize who you are. Never sacrifice who you are. Seniors, now it is your time, your opportunity to pursue the hopes, dreams, and passions that you have forged for years in your mind. It is now your time to build upon the foundation that you have created and construct the life and career that you have dreamed about. Now is not a time to relax. It is a time to redouble your efforts and dedicate yourself to making your grand dreams come true. Make sure you treat your high school education as a springboard and not a finish line. Although this is the end of your mandatory education, it is only the beginning of the unique course you choose to chart in order to navigate the sea of experiences you will encounter from this point forward. You have been provided the basic tools for the future. It is up to you what you now do with them. It is how you use these tools, hone them, and leverage them that will determine your successes in the future. Remember this day, the sense of pride and accomplishment that you take from it, and use that to move toward the next big goal. Congratulations, class of 2021.
The class of 2021 has had a journey to graduation that has been unique. On March 13th of 2020, California went into an unprecedented stay-at-home order in an attempt to level the spread of COVID-19. We all thought this would be for a short time. As you know, it was for more than a short time. Academic and social advancement was a challenge for the class of 2021. You have adapted to many new ways of doing things that previously were simple or normal. They became complicated or unusual. The United States Marine Corps purpose is to adapt and overcome. The class of 2021 has developed those attributes. You are here at an American rite of passage of graduation due to your abilities to adapt and overcome. We can also say at this time has been an opportunity for renewed family relationships, self-reflection, and goal setting. This time has had great value or great discount, depending on the point of view. Combined with the actions of each member of the class of 2021, there are lessons to be learned that can help you continue to make history. Please enjoy the journey. The ability to be flexible in all situations allows the class members to adapt to variables that are inherent to all people. Thanks to your teachers and administrators who have prepared you in person and online to move forward by adapting to whatever the next steps bring you. The class of 2021 and your teachers have been pioneers transforming education. Future innovations and techniques in education will be built upon the foundation of this educational experience, in part due to COVID-19 response. The class of 2021 has opened up possibilities and questions for education faster and more significantly than any class in American public education. Computers and software may revolutionize how people learn, but I believe we have seen firsthand that teachers are and will always be paramount in the art of instruction. In a graduation speech, Steve Jobs said, "We are here to put a dent in the universe. Otherwise, why else even be here?" Here in Lake Elsinore and around the world, you and your classmates have already begun to create a dent. I challenge you to continue. We find ourselves in a time of paradox, contradiction, and opportunity, and above all, change. To the fearful, change is threatening because they worry things may get worse. To the hopeful, change is encouraging because they feel things may get better. To those who have confidence in themselves, change is a stimulus because they believe one person can make a difference and influence what goes on around them. We all have the opportunity to choose which of the three will be. We have learned through this pandemic that words matter, actions matter, and people matter. Combining these three concepts as we move forward as a nation will be a quest for the members of the class of 2021. As you take on the future challenges, please keep these three concepts in mind. You will write history that will translate in many ways, but your intellect and ability combined with experience are a powerful combination for finding success in the future. Your goals will provide a roadmap for you to follow for success. Do what you love and it will always be satisfying. Focus on the journey and you will not find disappointment intolerable. You will feel ecstasy in the final result. The next few months and maybe even a year may still present obstacles and setbacks that seem to derail your journey or divert you from your goals. Stay strong and focused and keep family and friends close. They will help and provide strength and energy. I wish you all the success that your efforts and ability allow you, and congratulations to the class of 2021.
I'd like to welcome all of you here today, and we're so grateful that we're able to have this video and to be able to share with you our thoughts on this very important day for parents, students, and for staff. I feel like this is the most important talk that I've ever given in all my teaching or all my life, because I hope that it'll have an impact on some for the remainder of your life. One of the things that I would like to do is I would like to be able to go ahead and I'd like to do a thing called reframing. It's something that I learned when I was taking counseling classes. And reframing is when you can put a very plain picture into a very nice frame, and what happens is it just pops. And sometimes we can have things that are not nice that happen in our life that we need to reframe, and one of those is COVID. And I'd like to explain to you what I think is maybe a better way to look at COVID. There's a parable called the Parable of Kentucky Bluegrass Lawn. And this gentleman and his family bought this home, and it was in an area that was a little bit run down, and the home had been just not treated very well. He went ahead and he went out and he mowed the lawn, and amongst all of this dead lawn, he found this one spot, a green spot in that lawn. He was so excited about it. He got fertilizer, he watered, he did everything, and soon in about a week, that little spot had become a 3-foot spot. And then eventually it became half the yard. And he got very, very excited about that. Well, next door to him, there was a guy who had a Kentucky bluegrass lawn. And it was a lawn that was just so green, it was just almost blue. It was just a tremendous color. Well, he was panicked about that lawn that was next door. And he got so panicked that at first he just went out on his hands and knees and he crawled around and he looked to see if there was something that might come from that lawn that would kill his lawn. And as the lawn seemed to grow next door, he still got more panicked and started coming back and going back. And he was going back and forth. He's going up and down on his lawn, looking for lawn moss, crabgrass, anything that might kill his lawn. Well, after about a month, that old dead lawn was perfectly green and beautiful. And the Kentucky bluegrass lawn had just died away. And the owner of the Kentucky bluegrass lawn was just pulling it up by the roots, and he was throwing it into the ground, and he said, "I'm going to find out what killed you if it's the last thing I do." Well, he wouldn't have had to look far, because what happened is that all of his crawling with his hands and knees had compacted the soil so tightly that the roots could not be nourished. And sometimes it's that way with us, is that we wind up so much looking for the bad in things that we can miss that good, and we can wind up inheriting and even creating the bad because we spend so much time looking for it. I think that's what we need to do with COVID. We need to try and take a look and see what are the things that have happened. That certainly we can find tragedies and we can find things that were lost, sports, events, music, things that were lost for our students. But I think we also need to look at what were the life lessons that were taught. Learning never stops. And if you look at history, what you see is you can see events that our grandparents and our parents went through, World War II, the Cold War, Korean War. You look at all of those things that happened to them. We look at civil rights movements and things that happened that created challenges in people's lives. And yet still there was learning that was done. And people grew. And they grew because of what happened to them on the inside. I'd like to tell you another story, a centuries-old story of a young man who grew up in a wealthy home and decided he wanted to try life on his own. He thought he knew better and asked father for his inheritance. And he went ahead and he took that inheritance and he went to the big city. And he wound up going ahead and living a life that was maybe not, was a life mostly focused on him. And he spent all of that money. And one day he found himself lying with the pigs. And he was eating what the pigs were eating. And it was a wake-up call to him. And what happened to that young man is he came to himself. He just all of a sudden had a realization that there were bigger things in life for him to do. But it took that hard experience, that tough thing, just like our grandparents and our parents may have experienced, to be able to come to himself and to see what was really important in life. Sometimes we learn in the classroom. And sometimes we learn in life. There have been an exceptional amount of wonderful lessons that have been learned in this difficult, difficult time that we can take and apply for our entire life. We hope that you wind up developing strength from the challenges that you have. I want you to look around where you're at right now and just grab anything, a pencil, a bottle of water, and I'm going to put you through a strength building exercise. I'd like you to put it in your hand. I'd like you to start curling it. that pencil, that bottle of water. Now, I could ask you to do that 100 times, maybe even 200 times, and you might get tired, but you're not going to build any strength because there is not anything, any opposition that is putting back on you. And that's what happens. We can gain strength from these difficult times that we have had. And students, parents, grandparents, I hope that you will allow your student to look and see, what have I learned? What am I going to learn from this experience that is going to wind up making my life better later? I have found in my life that human beings are very resilient. When their back is to the wall, that is when often their best comes forth. And our back has been to the wall. Why does our back get to the wall, and why do we grow from there? It's because we begin to see things clearly in our life of what is important. As I said earlier, learning never stops. Whether we like it or not, what we get to do is choose whether we learn from the lessons that are provided. I think that the worst thing that we can do is create a belief that the sky is falling. Look at everyone who has grown. Look at your parents. Look at grandparents. Look at friends. Look at teachers. Look at coaches. Look at all of those people who have made a difference in your life. What lessons can you learn from them? What can you take? What lessons can you learn from this difficult time that we have had during COVID? If I could give you one last homework assignment, it would be, what have been the life lessons that you have pulled out? I would encourage you as families to talk about that. What things have we learned? What have been the benefits from this experience? What do we see more clearly now? And I hope it's not like that young man that changed his life by going to the city and spending all of his money and winding up having to go sleep with the pigs in order to be able to understand how important it was for him to see things clearly. I hope it will not be a life that is focused on living for the moment that often leads to an empty life, but rather it'll be a life rich in service and the ability to move forward in your life. The definition of graduation is a mark on an instrument or a vessel. This is no end. This is a commencement. And commencement means a beginning, a birth, a dawn, a kickoff, a launch, a start. The opposite of a commencement is a close, a conclusion, an end. This is not the end. Learning never stops. My wife Mary and I are coming to a graduation ourselves. We're stepping into a new part of life. Learning never, ever stops. God bless you to be able to continue that learning and to continue that choosing as you move on. On behalf of the board, the staff, and the teachers of Lake Elsinore Unified School District, good luck and God bless in your choosing.
Greetings and salutations, fellow graduates, friends, and family. I would like to start off by giving my thanks to the school faculty for their continuous help and support of all their students and their genuine care for their well-being. I want to thank my grandparents for always supporting me, but most of all, I want to thank my mom and dad for being inspirations and motivational outlets that I can always rely on. I can never thank you guys enough for the constant love. We have all been waiting for this moment for 13 years, and honestly, I believe there are no words I can use to describe this feeling of accomplishment. We have all worked so hard for this, and it's crazy to think about how different this whole year has been for everyone and what we've all had to get used to. It's astonishing how the past year has affected us and how we were able to prevail as 2021 graduates. We still have many trials and tribulations ahead of us, and it seems daunting, but I know this generation and my peers will do great things for the future. High school is a place you go to find yourself. I see so much individuality right now that I feel like high school did its job and it did it well. We have blossomed into promising young adults. Each of us have had our own unique experiences. We all have our story. Whether you are seeking higher education, going into the military, entering the workforce, the lessons we've learned here, both inside and outside class, will guide us for the rest of our lives. It is because of everyone here that we have a future to look forward to and that we are capable of changing that future for the better. This day is the closing chapter of many more books to come, so I want to congratulate everyone here and I wish you all nothing but happiness and prosperity. I would like to leave you all off with the wise words of Ferris Bueller, and I quote, "Life moves pretty fast. If you don't stop and look around once in a while, you could miss it." Thank you.
Hello, I'm Jasmine Fuentes, and I just want to congratulate my fellow graduates. Towards the end of my sophomore year, I thought graduating on time was impossible. And after starting Ortega, they gave me the opportunity that I longed for. Over the past year, life has been pretty hectic, and for some, even the years before. It felt like life was against us and was rooting for our downfall. It made us change in ways we never imagined. It made us stronger and wiser and gave us the strength to look towards the brighter path. And at the end of it all, no one can tell us that we aren't strong enough and that we can't make it, because the past year and even the 3 years before are proof that nothing can hold us back. I just want to congratulate everyone once again, the graduate of 2021. I'm proud of you all. Thank you.
Hello, and good morning, everyone. I want to give thanks to Jesus Christ for giving me this opportunity to graduate this year. I also want to give thanks to my family for being here. Now I want to share some of the challenges I faced in getting my diploma. Getting my diploma has been a dream since I was a little girl. I'm originally from Guatemala, and I was about to graduate there, but I didn't. I went 1 year to the high school, and after 1 year, the school said I have a speech problem. And I need to be in the special education program. I didn't know what the special ed program was. I thought I was still going to take normal classes, but I found out I wasn't, and I was heartbroken. I cried. I asked, why me? Then I went to two different schools that offer a high school diploma, but I stopped going because I didn't see any achievement, and it seems impossible to ever get my high school diploma. I didn't want to know anything about school, and I said, this is just not for me. But my brother said, you aren't going to give up on your dream. I don't know how you're going to make it, but you'll make it. So I kept praying about it, and God heard my prayer. In 2018, a girl from church invited me to her graduation from Ballet Adult School. I enrolled and started coming, and I was able to meet Mr. Carlos, a kind teacher and someone who always willing to help me. When the pandemic hit, I had to finish the courses online. Never in my life taking online classes, but Mrs. Vicky was so kind and lovely. She explained things very well, and she's always there when I have questions. Those are the two amazing teachers I met at Ballet Adult, and the best school I've ever been to. Thank you also to the principal, Dr. Cliff, for giving me the opportunity to speak today. I also thank you to all the staff who made this ceremony possible. We did it, guys. Congratulations to everyone in the class of 2021.
My name is Larissa Jefferson, and I am the counselor at Keith McCarthy Academy.
I am honored to address the graduating class of 2021. I am amazed at everyone for their endurance in getting to this point. No matter what obstacles were put in front of you, you persevered. This last year has been interesting, to say the least. Whether you worked on school from your house in pajamas with kids or a pet in your lap, or Zoomed from your bed or while driving, you have completed this major milestone in your life. This is the moment you worked hard for. It has not been without challenges, and I don't just mean TikTok challenges. The dictionary defines a challenge as a task or situation that tests someone's abilities. You were able to pass this test. I am inspired by each of you that faced every challenge head on, overcame every obstacle, and pushed every limit to rise to every occasion. You challenged yourself to work hard and meet your goals. Remember that this is not the end of your journey. It is just another turn. So as you continue along, whether you have it all mapped out or you're just taking the scenic route, challenge yourself to embrace every moment, because each moment shapes who you are. Continue to challenge yourself to be your best and believe that you can do anything. Congratulations, class of 2021.
Ladies and gentlemen, family and friends of the class of 2021, as president of the Board of Education of the Lake Elsinore Unified School District, it is my honor to accept the senior class of 2021 as graduates of the Lake Elsinore Unified School District. On behalf of the Board of Education, I congratulate each of you and wish you all of the best in the years to come.
Aaron Sorensen.
Hannah Allen.
Ariver Martinez.
Angelica Ambris.
Alejandra Molina.
Michaela Bailey Moraines.
Alejandra Zendejas.
Aspen Bain.
Alexander Aguilar.
Logan Barr.
Alyssa Gonzalez.
Wyatt Brown.
Sophia Quintana.
Eric Castro.
America Castillo.
Douglas Clark.
Anna Juarez.
Evelyn Davalos.
Anna Moreno.
Anthony Diamond.
Angel Martinez.
Elias Dominguez.
Angelica Sosa.
Vanessa Garcia.
Bianca Matamoros.
Dante Fava.
Brandy Miranda.
Madison Garnett Johnston.
Brandon Cabrera.
Tylen Green.
Camilla Barrios Ramirez.
Montana Guyman.
Christina Martinez.
Kaylani Harden.
Daisy Salcido.
Haley Henriquez.
Dante Navejas.
Valerie Hernandez.
Derek Pate.
Ernestina Hernandez Prado.
Evelyn Guzman.
Madison Ishisaka.
Emerita Crane.
Jada Kiskowski.
Indy Barrios Juarez.
Brandon Kenyon.
Flor Garfias Loza.
Shannon Kite.
Gia Maldonado.
Zachary Ty Corman.
Heather Romo.
Tegan Lancaster.
Henry Contreras.
Arlette Morales.
Isaac Diaz Garcia.
Andy Magdaleno Garibe.
Jacqueline Morales.
Eduardo Martinez.
Jaime Bravo.
Jonathan Naharo.
Janeth Duque Rocha.
Ja'Cory Neal.
Johnny Carrion.
Joanna Moore.
Joanna Santana.
Jasmine Amdahl.
Jose Tendano.
Ayana Orfe.
Joshua Pineda.
Hannah Placencia.
Justin Jimenez.
Michael Reynoso.
Kay Gibson.
Avery Rogers.
Luke Mendez.
Tiffany Saldana.
Lydia Guerrera.
Madison Schmidt.
Marcus Lobato.
Hannah Tedessa.
Maria Medina.
Marissa Truva.
Maribel Leon Rodriguez.
Mia Van Pelt.
Michael Dahlke.
Aubrey Vanderport.
Michelle Felix.
Christian Walter.
Nina Thompson.
Chris Williams.
Priscilla Palafox Avila.
Zachary Wood.
Rocio Sanchez.
Jacob Zambrano.
Samantha Saldana.
Melissa Gutierrez.
Shaney Tello. Shantika Gomez. Sierra Gaxiola. Sonia Herrera. Samara Chadwick. Stevie Lowe. Teresa Madrigal. Tyler Mazurall. Virginia Mendoza. Zachary Rexrode. Abraham Diaz. Alejandro Mojica. Andrew Fleming. Ashley Padilla. Anis Fernandez. Kylie Makor. David Cervantes. Samantha Jacobo. Jacinia Magana. Italy Figueroa Olivares.
Abner Hernandez.
Isaac Acosta.
Asia Bianca Espina.
Isaiah Canas.
Alana Dunn.
Jacob William Barnett.
Alejandro Cruz Arellano.
Jasmine Fuentes.
Alexander De Leon.
Jason Estrada Guillen.
Alexia Carbajal Studebaker.
Javen Harris.
Alina Lorena Cleveland.
Javier De Leon.
Elizan Angel Carrillo.
Jeannie Gorbulev.
Alyssa Chavez.
Jennifer Lopez.
America Angelica Friday.
Jermaine Barnes.
Anna Jimenez Rodriguez.
Jesus Luna.
Andrew Grijalva.
Jocelyn Castillo.
Anissa Baez.
Jonathan Cervantes.
Araceli Lopez Reyes.
Leona Jordan Gilliam.
Ariel Genevieve Cortez.
Jose Centeno.
Ashley Greider.
Joseph Ayala.
Viviana Garcia.
Josiah Huerta.
Brandon Bernardo.
Justin Garcia.
Renee Barnes.
Karen Eiler.
Brittany Laredo Espinosa.
Carissa Bennett.
Kaden Sillins.
Cassandra Gomez.
Kane Gomez Fuentes.
Kaya Kennedy.
Carlos Behar.
Cadence Livingston.
Chevrolet Lopez.
Kenny Fuentes.
Chloe Contreras.
Layla Lopez.
Cynthia Natalie Gomez.
Lamar Lamont Jones.
Zitlale Botello Castaneda.
Leilani Raquel Arnold.
Connor Lee Hall.
Lillian Escobedo.
Crystal Hauser.
Donovan Gastelum.
Delana Earls.
Marlon Wardado.
Daniel Alatore.
Matthew Becerra.
Devin Caimana Bailey.
Matthew Gonzalez.
Diana Marlene Busto.
Matthew Labitt.
Dominic Blumenreich.
Megan Clapperton.
Lorraine Fisher.
Eric Cruz.
Dewane Burrell.
Evan Barth.
Dylan Allen.
Mia Hensley.
Edith Gonzalez.
Mitzari Hernandez.
Eleni Guerrero.
Gavin Doyle.
Emily Garcia.
Miguel Libinow.
Ernesto Guerrero.
Morgan Ashley Dewar.
Giselle Lopez Pata.
Natalie Ahmad.
Hugo Castiglione.
Riley Gansky.
Esmeralda Galindo.
Oriana Chang.
Rebecca Evans.
Octavio Andrada Rivera. Nyleen Hussein. Rosalia Longargo. Samantha Gonzalez. Samuel Casterholm. Samantha Fernandez. Ruby Cabrera. Santiago Castillo. Saul Alaguirre. Savannah Gooden. Stephanie Hernandez. Vibriana Ibarra. Tyler Bublitz. Charlene Brambilla Camarillo. Victor Cantero. Zachary Bennett. Zachary Dohan. Zeta Corona. Zoe Luna. Devin Aguilera. Ezekiel Fonsaga. Carrie Conejo. Felix Anthony Areola. Pablo Baez. Janelle Denise Ibarra. Melanie Arispe. Karina Hernandez.
Abigail Mateo.
Frank Martinez.
Aldo Aguirre Valencia.
Gabriel Rodriguez.
Alejandro Najera.
Gabriela Mendez.
Alexa Tate.
Jaden Wardrip.
Alexander Viafana.
James Squires.
Alan Rubio Lopez.
Jasmine Resendez Sandoval.
Alyssa Weiss.
Javier Rodriguez.
Alex Pyle.
Julissa Quinn.
Angel Morales.
Jocelyn Ramirez. Andrea Mendoza.
Christopher Matiquito.
Alexis Ortega.
Angel Venegas.
Joy Rodriguez.
Annabelle Rodriguez.
Johnny Walker.
Anthony Riestra.
Johnny Punzalan.
Ariana Wright.
Joseph Romeo.
Austin Shaw.
Joseph Tovar.
Biani Rodriguez.
Joseph Ugaldi.
Brandon Resendez.
Anthony Isaac Wasso.
Brian Rivacava.
Joshua Manzanares.
Carlos Olivares.
Juan Sanchez.
Carlos Sori Ramirez.
Juan Rivera Valdevinos.
Carlos Feliz.
Justin Ramirez Shell.
Charles W. Valenzuela.
Kalani Portillo.
Cody Wah.
Khalil Overstreet.
Dalton Nelson.
Karina Reyes.
Daniel Paletti.
Catherine Reyes. Catherine Perez.
Bridget Murillo.
Kayla Vega.
Daniel Valdivia.
Logan Williams.
David Rodriguez.
Christopher Ramirez.
David Serrano.
Madison Ormsby.
Dayron David Padilla.
Michaela Say.
Delaney Nicholson.
Manuel Julian Olasaba.
Darren Caesar Patino.
Manny Martin.
Dwayne Price.
Marco Maldonado Contreras.
Diego Polito.
Marco Parra Rosales.
Donovan Nungare.
Marcus Up.
Edwin Nunez Ortiz.
Maria Medina.
Elijah Hayes Saldivar.
Melanie Valdovinos.
Erickson Reyes.
Michael Mayers.
Steven Rios.
Michaela Ward. Angel Santos. Miguel Martin. Miguel Mendoza. Miguel Paez Guerra. Miguel Zuniga Soto. Mohamed Rasul. Nicholas Manuel Meza. Nicole Martinez. Omar Rios. Oscar Adrian Ramirez. Rihanna Romero. Roman Torres. Rudy Troncoso. Ryan Placencia. Samantha Partida. Sergio Ponce. Seth Swanson. Seth Todd. Sophia Ogle. Talia Parker. Timothy Perez. Timothy Perry. Tori Ramirez. Ty Wheeler. Tyler McDaniel. Uriel Valadios Jr. Vanessa Schmidt. Viviana Alondra Velasquez. Jackie Vasquez Lopez. Zachariah Sanders. Zoe Reinhardt. Jacqueline Silva. Madeline White. Valerie Ramirez. Julian Silva. Saul Nava.
Looks like you made it. We made it. Always remember, if you can make it through this, you can make it through anything. Congratulations, class of 2021.